My name is Jung Hae-seo, and I'm in Youth Culture course. And it is a course that explains and introduces our culture to foreigners. Today, I'll tell you about National Hangul Museum. The first one I will tell you about is the path that Hangul has taken. The first exhibition is here. And it is on the second floor, and before explaining this exhibition, I'll tell you about Hangul. Now I'll tell you about Hangul. It was invented in 1443 by the king named Sejong in Joseon Dynasty in Korea. It is one of the few letters used by mankind that clearly identifies the creator and the year of creation. It is also considered the world's best character in that its creation spirit is in frequency, compassion, and practicality. Along with this spirit of creation, it is also outstanding in the originality and scientific nature of the principles of discipleship. This characteristic of Hangul has been recognized by international organizations. UNESCO gives the King Sejong Literacy Award in the world every year. The name of this award comes from King Sejong because the world recognized that Hangul, created by King Sejong, is the easiest to learn and is a good letter to get rid of illiterate. King Sejong made Hangul for his people because most people, common people, cannot read letters. In Joseon Dynasty, before Hangul is invented, Chinese characters are used, but these letters are too difficult to learn for the common people. And now, I'll tell you about this exhibition. It was made to show the history of Hangul and value of it. The exhibition shows the appearance of Hangul, which was created in 1443, and the process of the spread of Hangul in various fields, such as education, religion, life, art, publishing, and the mechanism. It also introduced the process by which Hangul gained its status as a Korean language in 1894, the result of Hangul research by various Hangul organizations and scholars that and the educational materials of the time. Various images and sculptures are also on display to see what Hangul looks like in modern time and what the potential for future development is like. A special exhibition. The second one is a special exhibition, and it is where various themes related to Hangul and world characters are planned and displayed. The main characters are Germany characters and Hangul, the Korean characters, and the exhibition covers not only relics but also works of contemporary artists covering the present and the future from the past of Hangul. The final one is a Hangul playground. It is an experience space where children can learn the principles of Hangul and express various thoughts through Hangul. You can experience the power and meaning of Hangul while having fun. It is suitable for children between ages of 6 and 9.